Hello students, this is module 3 session 2 about switching system software. In session 1 we learnt up to software architecture level 1 to 3. In this video we'll try to learn the next two topics. The first is digital switching system software classification. You'll get 8 marks question on this one. Digital switching softwares are classified into 5 types, but in the diagram only 4 are mentioned. The first two are clubbed. So the first one, switch feature software, this is the last one. Switch maintenance software. Switch software and maintenance software are represented in only one block, and you have office data software and afterwards feature software along with translation data. All the 5 softwares are connected to central processing unit. That central processing unit consists of a generic program. Already we learnt in the previous video. The generic program will contain every software. And you can observe in the diagram, you can observe blocked arrow mark and hollow arrow mark. This arrow mark represents direct interaction. That means there will be a hardware connection between these two. This arrow mark shows software dependency. So that means there is no hardware connection, but still to get information about the subscriber you need to get only software interaction between these two, and to have translation data you need to have only software connection. Let us try to know one by one what may be the functions of each software. I hope you remember the blocks mentioned in each level, because remembering that block is important. We'll start with the first one, switching software. Mainly there are 4 hardware blocks. To maintain that you need 4 softwares. You can remember from highest level. The highest level is having the processor, what we call it as CP. For that processor we need 1 software. And to connect one subscriber to another subscriber, we need a switching fabric to control that one software. And I hope you remember NCP for that one software. And the lower level of communication is line modules and trunk modules. We'll call it as peripheral devices. To control that, we have control software. That means 4 switch softwares are there. One for CP, switching fabric, NCP, line modules and trunk module. Then the second one, switch maintenance software. See, maintenance in a switching system is very important. What about the maintenance means? You need to get overall control. Whenever you are talking about overall control, it starts from first main function. I hope you remember 8 switching system function. The first one is scanning a line. So here it is called line test. Then you need to just check whether it is in same module or whether it is in another trunk module. It is about the remote diagnostics. And if something failure occurs, you need to recover the system. It is recovery. I hope if the level module fails, it is local recovery. If higher level module fails, means it is very crucial. We'll be following active standby mode for central processor and also NCPs. And afterwards you may be having a outside exchange connection, means it is the trunk test. So overall the recovery of the switching system is important. So here the maintenance software will be having the capacity to recover it efficiently. That means it has good recovery capacity. And this last point you need to remember, what are all the external support the maintenance software will give to the switching system. So one is remote programming and diagnostic. That means so you can diagnose the software where it may be connected in a longer distance, and you'll be having support from OSS, operational support system. Extra softwares or extra applications that to be added are supported. And to support that, you have another one, operator position support. For example, you can assume that you need to connect at NCP, means the connection should be supported at that position. and advanced features. So you can have extra features which will be added. So everything has to be maintained by the switching maintenance software. So then office data. So office data is very easier to understand. So what is needed here is, so you need one computer. So one computer will store every software and hardware. So where you need to get the concentration on few parameter. So office data. So office data defines some software parameters and some hardware parameters. So where it will be stored means, so you'll be having one computer. So inside that computer you'll be storing office data. So both softwares are actually stored here. Some hardware parameters are connected to them. So the extent of this one is connected to CPU. That means, so these programmable computer is connected to central office switching system. So I hope you remember the number of connections what we made in the digital switching system building block. The same thing is to be listed here. Try to remember at least four hardware parameters and software parameter. How to remember means, you need to remember the lower level of communication and higher level. So lower level means it is a line module, trunk module. Higher level means it is a central office. So like that you need to remember. Try to list out the point. Some general hardware parameters. So number of NCPs connected to central office. That means how many network controller pairs you are going to connect. And number of line controllers. Then number of line control configured. What is the difference between these two means? This is number of single subscriber. And you'll be having line module. To a single line module, how many lines has to be configured. Then similarly, the same thing could be connected for even trunk. See the second point, the total number of the trunks and the types of the trunks configured. You can list this also. And apart from that, you can easily remember this total number of line equipment in a CPU. That means how many subscribers you are going to connect to your central office. Then I hope be having called subscriber at one end and calling subscriber at the other end. To connect it, so dial tone has to be provided for the calling customer. For the called customer, you need to provide the ringing tone. So all those are listed here. Services such as ring units, DTMF, that means dual tone multi-frequency unit, and dial pulse. So what is dial pulse means? Whenever you press the numbers, you'll be hearing one sound. So that is the dial pulse. Then transmitter provided. These are all the hardware parameters. Then to maintain that, you need some softwares, right? So the first software which is listed is AMA register. Try to remember this. This is automatic message accounting system. Earlier in the landlines, you'll be getting phone bills. So how the phone bills will be getting means, in a switching exchange, whenever you start your conversation, this register will start, and whenever you disconnect a call, this register will stop. Automatically it will list the number of time you'll be communicating, and due to that communication, due to that time, it will be listing the cost of the communication. The first one is size of AMA, then number of AMA register connected to CO, and the number and types of traffic register, because whenever the communications increases, you need to concentrate on traffic also. Then size of offers of telephony functions. The next one is number of features which will be supported by it. So whether you remember last two, but try to remember the first three, it is easily rememberable. Size of AMA, number of AMA, number and types of the traffic register. So this is about your office data. Then translation data. The translation data differs from the office data. So here the subscriber actually specifies every data. For example, telephone number. The telephone companies actually list the translation data. All these will be listed in the computer itself. एंड इफ एनी डिटेल्स हैज़ टू बी गिवन फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर कंपनीज मीन्स दे कैन मॉनिटर द ट्रांसलेशन डेटा बिकॉज इट विल जस्ट शो द ट्रैफिक ऑफ दैट एरिया. एंड वाई द ट्रांसलेशन डेटा इज नीडेड मीन्स अर्लियर वी हैव लैंडलाइन कम्युनिकेशन वेयर द कम्युनिकेशन मे बी ISDR STD कॉल्स लाइक दैट रिस्ट्रिक्शंस आर देर दैट हैज़ टू बी लिस्टेड इन पर्टिकुलर टेबल. In digital switching system, that is actually called as database. The entry for translation data is a part of DSS. That means you need to list everything in a table. What may be the list of the table means? It may be assignment of directory to line equipment number. That means a customer has to be assigned to one particular line equipment number in an exchange. Then enabling the subscriber. So that means particular customer has called with particular details. That means, so it may be call waiting or it may be three-way calls. We'll call it as conference call or forwarding a call. All these are provided in the translation data. And even you can block a call. That means call restriction. That is no outgoing calls, call block like that. And you can have intercom and announcement calls. And I told about ISD STD, so where you need area code translator and you need to identify call route, then STD calls and international calls. That means, so you need to identify first numbers, for example 080. Afterwards it will be listed with particular number or it may be 08134 like that. So area wise code will be there. So inside the switching exchange it will be translated. Such datas are available in the translation data software. And the last one is a feature software. So where extra features, that means recent features, will be added here. The most of the recent packages are given as an example. It may be operator service, Centrex feature, ISDN basic rate, STP extension, SCP database. That means service providers and service control peripheral devices are needed here. Most of the generic program will be updated here. So usually in the generic program you'll be getting only base package. Along with the base applications, extra example packages will be added here. It is nothing but the recent softwares which will be go on adding to the fifth one. That is about the feature software. So most of the telephone companies have their own package. They'll be providing you, they'll be offering you depending on requirement of the switching system. That is about the classification of the software. And the second topic is call model, which is very important. Explain call models. This call model is depending on the functions of the switching system. You'll be having two methods to explain call models. One, you can remember the switching functions and you can explain. Otherwise, try to just differentiate between how many steps you need for connection and how many steps are needed for the disconnection. And whenever you write this flow, it should be in an order. You should not never miss this order. We'll try to go for this one. We have 14 steps given for connection sequence and 6 steps given for the disconnect sequence. So this will be very easier to understand if you have flow graph. Even you are going to learn this flow graph or flow chart in the 5th module also. Let us try to go for this. First one is a scan line. So what a scan line means? Testing a line. You can observe this. The customer A, it is calling customer, and customer B is a called customer. So you need to concentrate on this one. So whenever the customer A lift up the phone, or whenever the dial is not done, means has customer A goes half hook. That means, so still the receiver is not lifted up in the first diagram. What is happening here means continuous scanning is done. This is first function, scan a line. Then detect half hook. So what is the meaning of detect half hook means? So usually this is connected to the next step. The first subscriber customer A lifted the handset. At that time he has to hear the dial tone. So within 3 seconds the dial tone has to be heard. For that, whenever he lift up the phone, identify customer A line and associated features. That means the line has to identify. Then test customer A line for foreign potential. That means whether it has listed up correctly. So that testing has to be done. See here, test a line after lifting it. Then translate a line, whether it is STD code or ISD code, you need to check before connecting dial tone. Then afterwards the next step is connect a dial tone. See, all these three steps has to be done in 3 seconds, because when you lift up the handset you'll hear the dial tone. So all these will be done in a 3 seconds itself. So that is about your half hook. Afterwards, whenever you hear a dial tone, you start dialing the digit. See here, after lifting it is dialing. Provide dial tone to the customer A, then attach digit receiver. So what is this attach digit receiver means? So digit receiver means you need to press the numbers in the landline. So whenever you press it, you'll be hearing one sound. So that means one number is attached here. Whenever digit is attached, you need to remove the dial tone, right? Whenever you press a number, the dial tone will be removed and you'll be hearing only beep sound after first digit and collect the digit. I hope this is clear. Attach digit, then remove the dial tone after first digit and collect the digit. So they'll be collecting the digit. The next step, that is receive digits, is over. After receiving, you need to access network map. That means you need to search where is your called subscriber. See, for that we have analyzed the dial digit. Analyze it. If the dial digits are okay, for example, in through the landline, the area code is 5 and the another 4 numbers is 5, means you need to get 10 numbers. If you have dialed 10 numbers means it will proceed this way. So no means it will provide an announcement. That means you have not completely dialed the phone number. That means wrong phone number. So that means accessing network map, after that it has to just proceed the next step. So if your number is correct, request establish for a 2 subscriber. See here, order network connection. That means if your subscribers are correct, your phone numbers are correct, then both subscribers should be connected. Then hunt network path. After connecting, you need to hunt a path. That means check customer A line associated features, because you need to check whether this subscriber has got ringing current, because you need to give ringing current and afterwards he need to lift up the phone. So establish talk path. You need to establish the talk path still. Then ring called party. See, up to this the ringing is not heard by the called subscriber. So in this step, so he'll hear the ringing tone. See here, provide power ringing to the customer B, not to customer A. Power ringing should be given for customer B. See here. So here the subscriber A is lifted up, and after giving power ringing, so this subscriber lifted up the phone. See, whenever he lift the phone, remove the ringing tone, right? When the customer B answers, when he answers, you need to remove the ringing current. Then you need to provide a continuous path, right? Provide cut through path between customer A and B. That means they are talking. Whenever that communication stops means disconnected. That means call hangs up. The same thing, see here in the steps, detect answer busy. So if he answers, so he'll get a connection or he'll get busy tone. Then afterwards, update network map. So that means connect completely. Then whenever you need to start communication, you need to start a AMA register. AM means automatic message accounting. This is about what? Connection. In a disconnection, you need to follow the same thing. Scan a line. So here we have detect half hook. Half hook means you started communication. Whenever you want to disconnect it, it is in a reverse way, detect on hook. That means you actually put down your receiver. Then again test the line. Order path teardown. So here you need to order path connection. So here it is order path teardown. So why these steps are not there means you are not dialing anything. You are just, your call party has want to stop the communication. For that purpose, order path teardown. Then update the network map. If your calling is over means stop AMA timing. So in the connection sequence we started it. So here we stopped it. These steps has to be written in the same manner. See here. So scan line, detect half hook, test a line, translate a line, then connect the tone. Up to this is 3 seconds. Then receive digit, access map, order connection. Connecting, after connecting, hunt it, then establish path. Then connect the ringtone to the called number. Then if he answers, update the map and start timing. The same thing, scan a line, detect on hook, test it, order part down, that is tear down, update it, stop AMA timing. So maximum question paper consists of this. So this is very important question. In the next video, we'll try to go through the last topics. Thank you.